Now tell me exactly what happened this evening when you went to see your husband.
How did you know I went there?
It's my business to know things. Give me the details.
When I got to the house, the door was locked. I had a pass key.
How did you get that?
Please don't ask me that. I wanted to see Clinton without giving him a chance to prepare for my visit.
Go on.
We had a few words. He let his dog loose. Suddenly there was a shot. The dog was killed. Clinton rushed in. There was another shot and he fell dead.
Who fired the shots?
I don't know.
Was there anybody in the room besides yourself and Mr. Foley?
I didn't see anyone.
Could someone have been concealed in the room?
Either that, or someone might have fired the shots through the garden door.
Was the door open?
Yes. It closed right after the shots were fired.
What did you do?
All I could think of was running away. I knew that I might be suspected of having done the shooting.
I suppose you have no way of showing that you didn't do it.
No.
A gun was found lying on the floor. Was it your gun?
No.
Did you ever have a gun like it?
No, I never saw the gun. I tell you, I didn't have a thing to do with it. Why won't you believe me? I'm telling the truth.
All right, all right. We'll let it go at that. What happened next?
I had sent the taxi driver next door to call Arthur Cartwright, but he wasn't home. I was panic-stricken. I went out and had the driver take me back to the vicinity of my hotel. I figured that nobody would ever be able to trace me. I don't know how you found out about it.
Did you know that you left a handkerchief behind in the taxicab?
Good heavens, no. Where is it?
The police have it. I gave it to them.
I thought you were acting as my lawyer. They'll be able to trace me through that handkerchief.
That's all right. They're going to trace you anyway. And they're going to question you. You can't afford to lie to them, and you can't afford to tell them the truth. You're in a jam, and you've got to keep quiet. Do you understand that?
But that will prejudice everybody against me. It'll make everybody think I'm guilty. The newspapers will say that I refuse to talk.
Now, don't worry about that. You can tell the police and the reporters that you want to talk, but that I won't let you. Tell them that you could easily explain everything if I'd only give you permission to tell your story. You can even call me up on the telephone, in their presence, and plead with me for permission to talk. Put it on big. I'll sit tight and say that the minute you say anything, you'll have to get another lawyer.
Do you think I'll be arrested?
Certainly you'll be arrested. You let yourself into your husband's house with a pass key. You were there when he was murdered. You didn't notify the police. You registered at a hotel under an assumed name. Now, if you think you can pull a stunt like that and not get taken down to police headquarters, you're crazy.
Oh, I don't think I can stand it. How soon do you think they'll come for me?
Right now.